and welcome back to Let's Play Xenogears. We are about to go and defend Shevat from the assault that Solaris is launching on it. Now, as mentioned in the previous episode, there are four generators generating the shield around the city, and each generator is going to be attacked separately. Now, we broke into four different groups, one person and one gear at each shield generator. Now, at the first generator, I have Ellie. For very good reasons. And you're going to see those reasons in a few seconds once the battle starts. Now, see all those little guys on the ground there? There are soldiers. These soldiers will individually go and attack you in a group. That means there's six soldiers and two small gears standing there. And what these soldiers are going to do, they're going to bog you down into this irritating little nitpicking... They're going to kill you with bug bites, basically. So, what your best option is to do is to use these air rods here and kill all of these soldiers in one attack. Check this out. Bam! They're all dead. All that's left is these little gears here. And they are not very powerful. I mean, their attack is decent, but they have a very low HP, and one good hit will take them down. I'm gonna throw these... Oh, they missed. Basically, all the battles here, I'm gonna be throwing the gears into boost mode. Because they're short battles, I don't really have to worry about running out of fuel or using the frame repair or anything like that. See, go take this one down. Missed. Duh. Shouldn't have been using the X attack. And it's down. Ellie gets her experience points, and we move on. Oh, that's a nice level up. Silver armor. That is a good kind of armor. We'll equip that later. Generator 2, I have Bart. Now, Bart is going to be fighting three types of gears called White Knights. They're not very difficult enemies. And actually what I should have done was have Billy fight this fight. But it really doesn't matter. These enemies are weak. And they... Even if they hit you, they're not going to do any damage. The only reason why I should have used Bart is because it has better accuracy. Even if they manage to hit Bart, which none of them have so far, you're going to see that there's no damage. But Bart's accuracy is a little low, and he missed that one. See, that one hit and did no damage. That one hit and wasn't defended and still did no damage. Miss! See, the square attack from Bart didn't take him down, even though they're weak enemies. Now, Billy's square attack would have taken them down. Made a little bit of a mistake when I put these teams together. But none the matter. Just made the battle last a little bit longer. And Bart gets his experience. Next, we're gonna go to Billy. Over on Generator 3. Now, I should have had Side 10 in this fight, but Billy will do just fine. I'll take out these little bastards first. They're the White Knights that we had. Same kind of gear anyway that Bart fought. And the gear in the middle is stronger. Citadel. It's stronger and it'll take more of a beating, but not a whole lot. I mean, we'll be fine. a bit of damage to our Billy does to this one. Boost! Didn't have a level 3 attack. No, that was a fairly strong attack. And the enemy should be almost dead at this point. Miss. And that did it. Now Billy will get his experience and gold plate. I honestly forget what that does. Now we just have to finish it up with generator number 4, and Faye is there. Now this enemy here, you should have Faye do this, because at this point in the game, he should have the most powerful gear still, or the best for any situation, and this is the only battle that you really have to worry about. Have to really worry any about. Because this avalanche, see, that's how much damage its attack does, and that's like a regular attack. Even though I really don't have to, I'm gonna take down the White Knights first, because they still can't do any damage, so I just don't want them spending time attacking me. And they're dead, and Faye now has a level 2 attack ready. Jeez, that does a lot of damage. But with booster up, I get a lot of attacks in. And again, it's not a terribly difficult fight. It's just something that you have to know that you can't screw around with. And I'm gonna restore his gear, just to make sure. Didn't really have to. As we'll find out, the battle's almost over. It's over. Didn't even have to use the combo attack. Okay, we've successfully defended all the generators. Of course, it's not over yet. You don't stand a chance, buddy. Get the hell out of there. Oh, just blew him into nothing. See, these Shevat forces have no experience in battle. Thought he could take that thing. He was an idiot. Anti-gear psycho jammer. Yeah, it really said that. But what it did was disabled all the gears, so now we can't go and take him out. Because you have to move and do something first. Thank you. Of course, it's a little messed up to expect Maria to run out there and fight her own father like that. So she obviously, like, steps back. She doesn't want to do it. But here we have Chu-Chu here. That pink little bastard. Astronomically unintellectual looking low-level animal. And Chu-Chu wants to fight him. But Chu-Chu's got a bit of a surprise up her sleeve. Growing! Look at that. And we have a battle between Chu-Chu and Xenogears. However you pronounce that name. It's German, I believe, for 16. Now, Chu-Chu's attack, although it isn't extraordinarily powerful, you notice that Chu-Chu does not take any damage from anything that this monster does. Also, Chu-Chu is very limited in abilities, though. Chu-Chu cannot use any sort of combos, but Chu-Chu is capable of healing herself using ether attacks. It's a special ability that Chu-Chu has, and Chu-Chu can actually heal other gears. So if you have Chu-Chu in your group, you can have Chu-Chu heal a regular gear, so it doesn't have to use fuel or time to heal itself. However, the effectiveness of Chu-Chu is rather limited, and it's difficult for me to choose her in a battle, because her inability to provide a whole lot of damage. Now, the reason why Chu-Chu is able to do this is because Chu-Chu is one of the native, indigenous life forms of this planet, and it was originally a large species, but Solaris didn't like the idea of these gigantic furry animals running around. They had the ability to morph up and down, big and small, whatever. So, when they created their limiters, which are these nanobot things that they pump into people's bloodstreams that limit their thoughts and abilities, they did that to all the Chu-Chus to prevent them from growing to enormous size. Keep them controlled. Chu-Chu doesn't have a limiter, though. Oh, Chu-Chu's down! Speaks. Now, at the end of this battle, I'm going to end the episode. So tune in next time to see what we do about this red monster.